Hello and welcome back, everybody, to the Fall Nationals October season. Right now, we're going to kick off with a great interview with Luke Trotz from St. Francis University, the head esports coach there. So, Luke, thank you for joining me. How are you doing tonight?
Hey, I'm doing well. Thank you for having us. Real excited to be a part of it.
Awesome, awesome. Thank you so much for taking the time to come on. You can see his players behind him right now. They're starting that prep work and that warm-up session. They're competing in Madden, Hearthstone, and Fortnite later tonight around 8 o'clock in the ECAC. So super excited. Hope y'all win tonight. Definitely going to be cheering for y'all while we're producing over here. But I want to jump right into it. I'm going to ask you the first question. Just give me a quick overview of your program. You know, what kind of games do you compete in? Where do you compete? You know, give me that, you know, that vibe. Obviously, we see some of it behind you, but just take us through that snapshot of, you know, what a collegiate esports looks like at St. Francis.
Yeah, absolutely. We were the very first Division I esports program in the state of Pennsylvania. We're also currently the only program in the Western PA region with our own esports facility. So this is a dedicated facility for esports. Only esports takes place back here. It's not like a computer lab or anything. So our students can be in here from noon to 11 p.m. every day to practice or compete. We have Fortnite, FIFA, Hearthstone, League of Legends, Overwatch, Rocket League, Smash Ultimate, and... I can't think of the last one off the top of my head.
Yeah.
8 game titles. So there's a lot going on in here today. Sorry. And we have about 2 teams in every game title. So we field a few different teams throughout the evenings. And then in the arena here, we have 18 PCs, two Nintendo Switches, overhead monitors, as you see. Right now, we got some League of Legends Worlds going on above us for to watch those competitions. And then the big cornerstone of our arena for the experience for the students is that we have a dedicated gig of internet. So we wanted to make sure that connectivity and it was flawless for the students.
Awesome, awesome. Love to hear it. Love to see that dedicated support, right? Because that's so important, right? Providing the students with the resources so they can excel, especially into as they progress their collegiate career. But kind of going to my next question is, how would you say esports prepares students for a number of different careers? Obviously, the next step for all of your students and players is going into the workforce, right? Maybe whether that's playing professionally or just working in the esports general or another general field as well. So kind of take me through, you know, your opinion on how those how esports kind of helps them develop those very job prevalent skills as they progress into the workforce.
Yeah, absolutely. So just like traditional sports, these students are developing communication, teamwork, leadership, patience, discipline, all within the game. Those soft skills that we get through these types of experiences. And the benefit of esports is you're also getting a lot of technical skills. These students have to organize the matches, organize the leagues on their own, make sure their opponents are game ready at the set day and time of the competitions. They have to organize each other's schedules to have practice and navigate the competitions. So a lot of that day-to-day managerial experience that most people have in their workforce, regardless of what profession you're in, is the type of technical skills that these students are building, along with opportunities to enhance programs, such as our new website that we have here for our program, redflash.gg, where we have students writing match stories for us, doing summaries, statistics, and even... photography and shoutcasting right through that website. So we're developing a lot of those technical skills in addition to those soft skills that you learn through traditional sports.
Awesome. Love to hear it. It's basically like you're running an esports organization, right? That's the exact same skills that you need to be successful in any kind of pro org, right? Whether it's from the playing side or that, you know, web development or news or photography or those creative outlets. So that's awesome to hear that you can provide that platform and let them develop those skills in college. So, you know, when they go, they can get those great jobs from teams like G2 or SSG or Envy and people like that, those massive orgs. So that's awesome. Kind of going to my next question is, in your opinion, how should students develop themselves and their skill sets at that high school level to attract more attention from collegiate recruiters like you? You know, what do you look for that kind of separates certain students from the pack as you, you know, approach that recruiting process?
Yeah, absolutely. The first thing that we tell students is that it's just not about your ranking online. Those rankings are very subjective, and a lot of different variables can go into those rankings depending on your past experience and playing. So the number one thing students should know is that it's just not about your rank. It's not about that MMR. First and foremost, it's about you as an individual and how you're achieving that rank, how you're navigating your experience and navigating the relationships around you to be the best individual and the best player that you can be. And that will help you make sure that you find the right program that for you, whether it's in esports or traditional sports or just the right college campus in general. It's about the type of person you are and the type of person you want to be, and that will help you find the right college campus for you.
Yeah, absolutely. Couldn't agree more. You know, once you hit that certain threshold in any game, with MMR doesn't matter, rank doesn't matter. It's all about who you are. You know, how do you focus on your character? How do you bring your teammates up? Totally agree there on everything you just said. But unfortunately, we are out of time. We got matches to hop into and cover the October season of the Fall Nationals. Thank you again for taking the time. Real quick, if you will, Luke, go ahead, plug your program. Where can we keep up to date with you? Obviously, you said your website at redflash.gg. Obviously, everybody check that out. But also, you know, where are those social media handles that we can follow so we can keep up to date in everything St. Francis?
Yeah, definitely. You can connect with us on all platforms through that website. But if you search for just St. Francis Esports on any of the platforms, you'll be able to find us. So feel free to reach out to us on there or email at esports@francis.edu. Love to hear from you and have some of you visit campus. Good luck in your matches tonight.
Awesome, awesome. Yep, like I said, everyone, we are going to be transferring. So, Luke, thank you so much for taking the time to come on once again.